Welcome back to Tangata Pasifika. This month is Blue September, which is a national awareness campaign for prostate cancer in New Zealand. It's the most common cancer among men here, where around 3,000 are diagnosed each year, and the most recent figures show 83 Pasifika men are living with the disease. John Pulu met a cancer patient in Wellington who wants to change the stats.
When we met Tuta'i Hewitt, he was busy in the kitchen preparing a treat for us.
So what are you making there?
It's bangi popo. It's a coconut green bun. It's a sweet bun.
It's the Pacific way, making sure the guests are well looked after.
And people say, hey, do you have a machine that makes the... No, I don't. This is my machine.
However, 6 years ago, it was his health that needed attention.
I had headaches, very different from the normal headache, is not enough rest, and back pain is very sharp, and my legs are heavy, you know, it's... So I said to my wife, hey, it's not right, something wrong.
The 54-year-old father of seven was diagnosed with prostate cancer, which is when the prostate gland becomes cancerous and forms a tumour.
I just say to the doctors, I don't think you're... Are you sure? Because I know I'm active, and I know I don't have any other illness or other weakness of medical side.
1 in 10 Kiwi males will get prostate cancer, and most develop it in their 60s, but it can occur even earlier. So age is a risk factor, as is a family history of the cancer.
I've done my operation, done radiations. Right now I'm on medication as drugs for 3 months. Because the last 6 months I went for my follow-up check with my doctor, and he said it's coming back. So I thought, whoa, what's next?
Tuta'i's Samoan Kukanan family are backing him all the way, trading their locks to fundraise for cancer treatment.
For me, it's more the money that you raise out of head shave, and that is going towards research and, you know, treatments, especially for the other types of cancers that are still in research.
Prostate cancer in New Zealand is increasing, and there's concern more Pasifika men are out there with the disease while not seeking help.
I think we don't talk about it. You know, it's the silent killer.
So a Pacific Men's support group was set up in Wellington to do something about it.
It's a safe place to come and tell our stories, to share, and that there is support out there. And that's one of the, what we've got our group as well, is to, you know, reach out to the, you know, the Pacific Island men and their families as well.
For Tuta'i, the best medicine is to be happy.
Are you afraid?
No. No, no. As I said, I'm happy, and take it as it comes, as day by day. I just always positive, and I always have that attitude. Don't let the cancer drive you. Drive the cancer. And that's where I'm at.
Well, joining me today to talk more about prostate cancer in our community is Dr. Abu Talemaitoga. Thank you for joining us on the show, and the blue glove.
The blue glove. It's blue that, September.
Right. And this is the thing that most men fear, is that right?
They do.
It's a big fear for it.
But as the Prostate Cancer Foundation says, we need to man up, not be embarrassed. You don't need to die of embarrassment. Go and see your doctor and talk about the blue glove.
I can see why that would scare a lot of men, actually. But how great is it amongst our Pacific community in terms of our Pacific men not wanting to go and get checked?
It is quite a big issue for our Pacific men. As you know, Pacific men don't normally go to doctors. It's the carer being the staunch one at home, right, looking after the family. But it's really about encouraging every man, but in particular our Pacific men, to go and at least have a conversation. Talk about what are their fears, what's going on. Talking about how tests can be done, examination by the doctor.
That blue glove is really distracting me right now.
I might take it off to help you.
Well, tell us, how simple was the process anyway for the test?
The process is very straightforward, because prostate cancer is a complex illness, but that's where the discussion with the doctor is really important, as to whether you've got a family history, which is really important, whether dad, your uncle or brother had it. That might mean tests earlier on. So, and the doctor will ask you about symptoms of difficulties, stop and starting, having to maybe get up several times in the night. All those things can be done as a screening test. And the doctor will explain the right tests that are appropriate for you. A blood test, an examination, a prostate examination, which a lot of men fear, and how often that should be done.
Are there a particular age group or risk factors amongst men that...
If you've got a family history, then you probably should start sooner, in your 40s. Most prostate cancer happens in the ages of 50 to 70. So every man that's 50 plus needs to see their doctor about having this test.
Okay. And we saw a couple of the symptoms from the gentleman in the item, but what are the symptoms then, in case there are men watching that might be thinking, is that me? Or?
The worrying thing is sometimes there will be no symptoms and you've got prostate cancer, which is why it's important to at least have the test or have the discussion before the test. The symptoms I mentioned are difficulty stop starting when you go to pass urine, maybe having to get up several times in the night, and things like that. But it only really comes out once you've started the discussion with your health
professional. So it's so important to go to the doctor.
It is very important.
What about for men who are diagnosed? What's generally the outcome for our Pacific men once they are told they've got prostate cancer?
Very good question. The statistics for Pacific men aren't that good yet, but we need to keep collecting the data. What we know from our Māori population is that when men get diagnosed, Māori men are 72% more likely to die of prostate cancer than others, which means there is still that health literacy, that discussion and explaining as to the options that are available.
Is it because men have left it too late? I'm just thinking for the Polynesian.
That's one of the issues, leaving it too late, but also just being so staunch and having the diagnosis done and not wanting to at least explore what are the options. Not every prostate cancer needs an operation.
Right.
Some of it just needs a sort of a yearly examination or discussion with your doctor. So it's just really important to go in.
Is there anything that men can do, I guess, to lessen their risk of getting prostate cancer?
Yes, there are some really good evidence that maintaining a good healthy weight, having less fats in your diet, having doing a lot of exercise, and lots of fruits and vegetables in your diet.
Okay.
All the generic things, they do help.
All those dads out there, uncles, brothers listening, make sure you take this on board. But what do you want to say especially to our Pacific Island men listening?
I would like to say that your family needs you. Your children, your grandchildren, your wife and your partner needs you. So please go and talk to your doctor. Have the conversation. Man up and be strong about the conversation about prostate health.
Okay.
And in that way, you can talk about the tests and how you can manage it.
Thank you for coming on the show. You can put that glove back on.
Thank you.